Okay, let us start this exercise 6.2, first question. So now find the values of x and y, then show that AB is parallel to CD. Look at this diagram here, we have two lines, AB and CD, we have to prove that they are parallel. Before we prove that, we have to find out the values of these angles x and y. So you need to find the value of this angle, you need to measure the angle x. And angle, you have to find out this angle, angle x and y, so these two angles. So if you show that these two angles are equal, then I can write AB parallel to CD. So let us see that in the diagram. Look at this, this 50 degree angle and x, 50 degree plus x, they are linear pair. So you can write equal to 180 degree. Both are linear pair. So therefore, you can find the value of x as x is equal to 180 minus 50. So x value is equal to 130 degrees. So you got the value of x. Same way, you need to find the value of y here. So y and this 130 degree, look at that, what kind of angles they are, vertically opposite angles. Angle y is equal to 130 degree. The reason is vertically opposite angles are equal. Vertically opposite angles are equal. We have proved that one. So therefore, you got the value of y also. Angle y is also equal to 130 degree, x is also equal to 130 degree. Therefore, you can write, so x is equal to y, both are equal to 130 degree. And look at the diagram, x and y, what kind of angles they are?
So they are alternate angles.
But these two are angles are alternate interior angles. Once the alternate interior angles are equal, then I can conclude that line AB is parallel to line CD. So that's the proof. We have proved that AB and CD are parallel to each other. You got it? You understood this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Have you noted? All of you have noted this, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Then I will go to question number 2 now. Second question. In figure, if AB parallel to CD and CD parallel to EF, CD parallel to EF, and Y is to Z is equal to 3:7, find X. We can draw the diagram like this. There are three lines and a transversal. So now let us label this first line, we call it as AB, and then second one is CD, third one is EF, and the transversal, you can see it is intersecting at three distinct points. And the angles that they have given is, first one, this is x, and the second one, this one is y, third angle, this is z. It is clearly given AB is parallel to CD and CD is parallel to EF, and the y is to z they have given, it is 3:7. So first let us find out the values of x, y, z. In this diagram, observe that this y and z, you can equate them to 180 degrees.
Sir, y plus z is equal to 180 degrees.
See, the vertically opposite angle of that one.
Sir, we can, sir.
Sir, vertical opposite angle of y, angle z is equal to 180 degree. Yes. So here in the diagram, just you can give this names to this point of intersection, transverse of where it is intersecting. This point P, this Q, you can call some other point R. Okay. So now angle, or otherwise, just you call this angle DQR. In the diagram, you can write angle DQR is equal to y. So reason is vertically opposite angle. Vertically opposite angles. And then this angle will be equal to, I can write this is also equal to y. Okay. Now y plus z is equal to 180 degree. You can write. What you can write?
So 3x plus 7x is equal to.
Y plus z is equal to 180.
3x plus 7x is equal to
180. Opposite angles will be equal.
Co-interior angles.
Interior angles on the same side of transversal. Or co-interior angles. You can mention any one of this. So now y:z is given 3:7. Suppose, so we have, look at this, we have y:z is equal to 3:7. So if I take,
excuse me, sir.
Y is equal to 3a, then z will be equal to 7a. If I take y is equal to 3a, z will be equal to 7a. Then you substitute this value in this equation. Okay, you call this equation
1. 7a is equal to 3a
plus 7a is equal to 180 degree.
Yes. Substitute in 1, you will get y means 3a, z means 7a, you will get 180 degree. That is 10a is equal to 180 degree. So it implies a is equal to 180 by 10.
A is equal to 18 degrees.
Please, 18 degree. So now you can find out the value of y. So y is equal to, it is 3a. That is 3:18 degree. What is the value?
Sir, 54.
Sir,
54 degree.
54.
We got the answer of y. It is equal to 54 degree. What is the question they asked? To find the value of x. Using this y, can you find out the value of x? How can you find?
Sir, so because x and y are... Sir, interior angles on the same side of the transversal, so angle x plus angle y is equal to 180 degree.
We have x plus y is equal to 180 degree. They are interior angles. Interior angles on the same side of transversal. So now, x value keep as it is, but y value calculated that as 54, write that one, it is equal to 180 degree. So x is equal to 180 minus 54.
So 126 degree.
6, 7 minus 5 is 2, and 1 as it is, 126 degree. So you got the value of x here. So this is the question they asked you. So you can write. Z, no need to find out here. What is the value of here? If they ask Z also, you can find out. Now they asked only the value of X. So it is equal to 126 degree. Any doubt in this?
No, sir.
You can note down this. If any doubts is there, you can ask me now itself.
Sir, please explain it once again.
Okay. Just you look at this. Here. DQR, DQR, look at this angle, DQR, okay, and Y, both are equal. Can you tell me what is the reason? DQR and Y both are equal. What is the reason? They are vertically opposite angles. DQR and Y are equal because they are vertically opposite angles. Okay, so therefore, Y, and again you look at this diagram. These two angles, these two angle equal to 180 degree. Okay, what is the reason? Because that's why we have written y plus z is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so we have written y plus z is equal to 180 degree. Now, so using this, again you come to this one. What they have given in the data? So now look at this diagram here, y plus z, y is to z is equal to 3 is to 7. So it is given in the question itself, y is to z is 3 is to 7. It is a ratio, they are given. If you take y as 3 into a, then z will become 7 into a. Ratio can be multiplied by any common number. Okay, so therefore, y if you take 3a, then z will become 7a. So we have taken y as 3a and z as 7a. So substituted this value in the equation. This equation. You can substitute this value in the equation 1. So y plus z means y value you can write it as 3a. Z value you can write it as 7a. So 3a plus 7a becomes 180. Got the value of a as 80 degree. So you see this. A is equal to 18. So once you get A, you can calculate Y value and Z value. So because Y is equal to 3A and Z is equal to 7A. So let us calculate the Y value. 3A, you substitute 3 into 18 degree and you got it as 54 degree. So now Y value, after getting Y value, look at the diagram now. Look at the angles X and Y there. When you see that X and Y, because AB and CD are parallel to each other, X and Y should be equal to 180 degree because they are the interior angles on the same side of the transducer. Allied angles, co-interior angles. So X plus Y must be 180 degree. Use that relation. X plus Y is equal to 180 degree. So keep X as it is. Y value you calculated already 54 degree. Substitute that one. So you get X is equal to 180 minus 54. And that is the answer, 126 degree. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So we will go to the next question. Question number 3. In the same exercise, if AB in figure, if AB parallel to CD, AB parallel to CD, EF perpendicular to CD, EF perpendicular to CD, and angle GED is equal to 126 degree, and find the angles AGE, second angle GEF, and then third angle FD. FD. So we need to find the three angles. Let us draw the diagram. The given diagram is like this. They have given two lines which are parallel. AB and CD are parallel to each other. So these two are parallel lines. Then we have two line segments here. One is perpendicular to this one. And then one more line. Like this, you can label like this. So AB parallel to CD. These two lines are parallel. AB and CD are parallel. Then EF perpendicular to CD. So this is E and this is AF. This is G. Okay. Here perpendicular line. So this angle must measure 90 degrees. So this angle is 90 degrees. Okay. So that is 90 degrees because they are perpendicular lines. Perpendicular. Perpendicular to CD means perpendicular to AB also because AB and CD are parallel. They have given angle GED is equal to 126 degree. So it is given that angle GED. GED means this angle is 126 degree. Look at the diagram. Angle GED is equal to 120 degree. Can you find out GEF using this? Is it possible to find out GEF?
Yes, sir.
How?
Sir, 126 minus 90 degree.
Yes. You can split this angle like this. Angle GED can be written as GED is the sum of these two angles. GEF plus FED. Okay. GED it is given, it is 126 degree is equal to GEF we need to calculate. GEF plus FED you have, that is 90 degree because EF is perpendicular to CD. So therefore angle GEF is equal to 126 degree minus 90. So what is the value?
36
degree.
36
degree.
So you got the value of one angle. Out of three you calculate the first angle, that is 36 degree. You can mention this angle. It's 36 degree. Okay, you can see the diagram. That small part of that triangle, that angle GEF is equal to 136 degree. So then, look at the diagram. Is it possible to find out FGE?
Yes,
sir. Yes.
How?
Yes, sir.
How can
sir.
You find?
Sir, first we can find the angle.
Can you write angle AGE is equal to?
Going to the angle.
AGE is equal to GED. Whether these two angles are equal or not?
Yes, sir. They are equal.
So
because they are alternate interior angles.
So you can write that they are equal to 126 degree. Both are equal to 126 degree. So alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. Okay. Because AB parallel to CD, GE acts as a transversal. Now, and using this angle AGE, you can find out this angle. What is that angle? That is E, G, F or F, G, E.
F, G, E.
Okay. So we will write in the diagram in the figure A, G, E plus F, G, E. F, G, E. Both are equal to 180 degree. So I can write that they are linear pair. So now you substitute A, G, E value. We have 126 degree plus F, G, E. Is equal to 180 degree. So therefore angle FGE is equal to 180 minus 126 degree. So angle FGE is equal to 180 minus 126. What is the value? 10 minus 6. 4.
54, sir.
54 degree. So you got the third angle also, the second, the FG, that third one you calculated. We got the second one, third one. We need to find out AGE. AGE also we calculated. AGE is 126 degree. So all the three angles we calculated. So we calculated AGE, we calculated DEF, we calculated FG. All the three angles are found out now. Is it clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If you have any doubt, you can ask me this.
Sir.
If it is over, then I will move to the question number 4. Okay. Write down question number 4 now. In figure, if PQ parallel to SD, if PQ parallel to SD, angle PQR is equal to 110 degree and RST and angle RST is equal to 130 degree. Find QRS. Find angle QRS. So let us draw the diagram for this. Here we have two lines AB and CD. Sorry. We have two lines PQ parallel to ST. PQ parallel to ST. One line PQ another line, then we will draw the line segment joining these two. Okay, like this the lines are this is R, this is S, P. And it is given that PQ, this line is parallel to this line. They are parallel, PQ and ST are parallel. We need to find angle QRS. This angle we have to find out. Angle QRS, this angle we have to find out. So with this diagram, it is not possible to find out. So we need some construction here, extra work we have to do. So we have to draw
a parallel line
to PQ through the point R. So you have to draw a line like this. You can call this as XY parallel. You can call this as XY parallel to PQ. So you can write the construction here, draw XY parallel to PQ. Draw XY parallel to PQ. Now what are the angles that they have given? PQR is 110 degree. You can mention this angle. This angle measures 110 degree. And then RST. This angle.
It is 130 degree.
Okay. It is 130 degree. So, using these two, you need to calculate this angle QRS. Tell me what you can do here to find out angle QRS. First step, can anyone tell me? I have
sir,
given.
First, we should find out the measurement of angle QRX and angle RXY. Sir, SRY.
SRY.
Very good. Very good. So now let us find out the angle QRX. Look at that PQR and QRX. They are the co-interior angles.
Sir, what?
Sorry, interior angle. Yes, Q. Interior angle on the same side of the transversal. So you can write here angle PQR plus angle QRX. Both are equal to 180 degree. So you can write co-interior angles. So now you substitute PQR is equal to 110 plus QRX is equal to 180 degree. So QRX is equal to 180 degree minus 110 degree, it is equal to 70 degree. So we have calculated this angle, this small portion. So here this one. You got this angle as 70 degree. Okay. Now similarly, so let us highlight this. This is 70 degree. Similarly, we can calculate ST parallel to RY. We have PQ parallel to XY. PQ parallel to XY. And PQ parallel to ST. So which implies ST must be parallel to XY. You have to show that one. ST must be parallel to XY. So therefore, angle PSR plus SRY both are equal to 180 degree. PSR is given, that is PSR or RST, both are same. 130 plus SRY is equal to 180 degree. So therefore angle SRY is equal to 180 minus 130. So it is 50 degree. So you can write this as angle 50 degree. So this angle, now we calculated this small angle. This is 50 degree. Now tell me QRS, we can calculate in one step. One more step we require. Tell me what is, how to calculate QRS.
Sir, angle QRX plus
angle SRY is equal to 180 degree as supplementary.
Okay, total should be 180 degree. You can see the diagram. Since XY is a line, sum of these three angles should be equal to 180 degrees. So in figure, just observe in figure, angle QRX plus QRS plus SRY must be equal to 180 degree. Other three angles should be equal to 180 degree. Substitute the values. QRX here 70 degree plus QRS you write as it is. Plus SRY we have 50 degree, it is equal to 180. So therefore QRS is equal to 180 minus 120. So therefore QRS is equal to
60 degree.
So 60 degree. So you have calculated this angle QRS. So that's you understood this?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Important point you need to know, that construction part XY parallel to PQ. Why? You have to think. Is it over?
Yes, sir. Finished.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we will go to the question number 5 now. Question number 5. Item in figure. In figure, if AB pair at the CD, if AB pair at the CD, and angle APQ, angle APQ is equal to 50 degree. And angle PRD is equal to 127 degree. Find x and y. Find x and y. So the diagram will draw. We have AB and CD two parallel lines. So these are the two parallel lines, and we have line segments like this. You can label like this. First one, AB parallel to CD. Then this is point P, Q. This is R. The angles given are like this. This angle APQ. So this measures 50 degree. PRD measures 127 degree. This angle. This angle measures 127 degree. You have to calculate the values of x and y. So this is x, this is y. Anybody tell me how you can
have to find the value of x
and y? Sir, angle and y. Sir, exterior angle property we can find the value of y.
Right now we cannot use exterior angle property because we are going to discuss next.
Sir, angle. Sir, 127 degree. Sir, after alternate interior angles.
Yes, very good. So you can write here angle APR. Look at the diagram in figure. You can write APR is equal to PRD. Both are equal to 127 degree. Reason is for interior and alternate angles. They are alternate angles. Alternate angles. There are alternate angles. You can see AB parallel to CD. You can take that PR as a transversal. PR as a transversal. Only you see the line PR, AB, CD. Okay. So then you will get angle APR is equal to 127 degree. So therefore, you can write angle APR is equal to 127 degree. APR, you split that angle. APR can be split as APQ. So it is the sum of angle APQ plus QPR. So both are equal to 127 degree. APR can be split like this because APR is equal to APQ plus QPR. So now you substitute APQ is equal to 50 degree. And this is y is equal to 127. So y is equal to 127 minus 50. Y is equal to 7
77 degree.
So you got the value of y now.
Sir, angle PQR is equal to angle APQ, sir. Sir, next, sir. Sir, angle APQ is equal to PQR because PQ is a transversal, sir, for AB and CD. Then angle APQ and PQR will become alternate interior angles.
Okay, fine, good. So look at the diagram now. So we have AB parallel to CD. We have AB parallel to CD. I can write APQ, angle APQ is equal to angle PQR. So because they are alternate interior angle. Look at the diagram and find out that they are alternate interior angles. APQ is equal to 50 degree. So you can write there 50 degree. PQR is equal to X. Therefore, X is equal to 50 degree. So you got the values of X and Y. Over?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Take down the last question of this exercise, sixth one. PQ and RS are two mirrors. Place it parallel to each other. Parallel to each other. An incident ray AP strikes. Mirror PQ. At B, the reflected ray moves along the path. BC and strikes the mirror RS. At C and again reflects back. Along CD. Prove that AP parallel to CD. So let us draw the diagram here. So here two lines we'll draw for the mirrors now. So these are the two mirrors. So this represents the rough surface. The other one is reflecting area. The red line shows the rough surface, back side of the mirror. So that represents a mirror. Both are mirrors now. Here we can call this as two lines mirrors. This is PQ and RS are the two mirrors now. Okay. Then what is happening here? AB is the incident ray. AB is the incident ray. So we can take one ray here. Like this. Then it reflects. An incident strikes at C. Then again it reflects back. So you will call this as A, B, C, then D. This is a ray striking at B, then reflecting back, incident at C, then reflects back. So we have to show that AB parallel to CD. So let us draw the perpendicular lines when a ray incidents or strikes the mirror. You know that loss of reflection, angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So you can draw the perpendicular lines here. This is perpendicular line. Here also we can draw one perpendicular line. Okay, you can draw two perpendicular lines there. You can call this as, this is E and this is F. Okay, so let us mention that one. Draw BE perpendicular to PQ, and then CF perpendicular to RS, because they are normal. We call that as a normal. In physics you have studied. So normal divides this angle into two equal parts. You can say this is angle 1, this is angle 2. Angle 1 and 2 are equal. So angle 3 and 4 must be equal. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So we have I is equal to R. I and R represents angle of incidence and angle of reflection. So therefore angle 1 is equal to 1 is equal to 2, and then 3 is equal to 4. Okay, angle 1, angle 2 are equal, angle 3, angle 4 are equal. Using the law, angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. We have to prove that AB parallel to CD, but you look at that given PQ and RS are parallel. So we have PQ parallel to RS. PQ parallel to RS and the perpendiculars. So we have BE perpendicular to PQ and CF perpendicular to RS. So therefore you can write BE must be parallel to CF. So BE and CF are parallel. If they are parallel, angle 2 and 3 must be equal, which implies angle 2 is equal to angle 3. Why? Can you tell me? What is the reason?
Sir, alternate interior angles.
Look at the diagram. 2 and 3 are equal because they are alternate interior angles. Okay. So we have 1 and 2 are equal. 2 and 3 are equal. So 3 and 4 are equal. So this will call it as 1. Look at these three equations now. What you are having? 1 is equal to 2, 3 is equal to 4, and 2 is equal to 3. So you call this as 2. From 1 to 3, what you can come to? From 1, 2, and 3. From 1, 2, and 3. Angle 1 is equal to angle 2 is equal to angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Isn't it? All the four angles are equal to each other, sir. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So now yes, you sir. Add this angle 1 plus 2. I can write angle, so you can call this as angle 1 plus 2, you take in the one side, should be equal to angle 3 plus 4. Angle 3 plus 4. That means angle ABC should be equal to angle BCD. Isn't it? All are equal, no?
Yes,
one
sir.
Side two angles, other side two angles means both angles are equal. Say all four angles are equal, 1, 2, 3, 4, all are equal. We have taken one side two angles, 1 and 2, other side we have taken two more angles, 3 and 4. So left hand side and right hand side both equal. You can take left hand side as ABC. Look at the diagram 1 and 2, it gives you ABCD, ABC. Then 3 and 4 gives you BCD. ABC and BCD, look at the diagram and tell me what kind of angles they are. Look at the diagram.
Sir, alternate interior.
Sir, alternate interior angles.
Sir, alternate interior angles.
Yes, but these two are alternate interior angles. So once the alternate interior angles are equal, you can call that lines AB must be parallel to CD. So that's the proof. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
So we have proved that AB and CD are parallel to each other.
The main reason is these two angles, we have proved that ABC and BCD are equal. These two angles are alternate interior angles. Okay.